Jason Cherry. I'm from Austin, Texas. I'm a bass player, musician, producer, keyboardist, all of the above. I've been playing music for about 16 years. It's been a long journey. I've been learning a lot. And so today, I just decided to make a video. I'm new to YouTube, so please like and subscribe to my channel. I'll be posting more videos. I enjoy this kind of stuff. But yeah, today, the intent of the video was to kind of demonstrate the different qualities and sound of the boutique basses that you see in the videos. So the thing is, I'm not trying to debate between whether Ken Smith bass is better than a Federa or Federa is better than Ken Smith. I'm just trying to demonstrate the different qualities and sounds. I will let you pick which bass is best for you or sound better for you. It's the same sound, same song, sorry, and different sounds, you know, kind of mixed up in the bass. So the thing is, you know, I decided to make the video because, you know, when I got into the boutique bass market, as far as like looking for one, I just didn't know what to look for. I was completely just overwhelmed with the different brands. There was Alembic, there was Ken Smith, there was Federa, there was Roscoe, there was Michael Tobias Designs. There was so many different companies and luthiers out there. So one of the things that I wanted to share was that, you know, you may think, why would somebody ever spend over $2,000 or $1,000 on a bass? Don't worry, I was exactly the same way. I was like, I would never spend more than what I spend on my Yamaha TRB. I love the Yamaha TRB. I played it for many years, and I was like, that's my main bass. Until I stepped into a store in Austin that sold all kinds of boutique basses. I stepped in there, and I didn't know what to play. I was just like, just give me that one. And I started playing it, and I was just like, oh my goodness. The sound, sonically, was out of this world. And it was a Ken Smith at the time I was playing. It was a White Tiger, to be specific. And I was just like blown away. I was like, it's no way I could go back to my Yamaha after playing this bass. It's kind of like driving a Ford and then end up driving a Mercedes. And how do you go back to the Ford after that? So, yeah, I started to dive a little bit more into the boutique basses, but I still didn't know what I wanted to look for. I still didn't understand what wood combinations could do to the sound, what electronics could do. I just didn't understand anything. So, you know, it was kind of overwhelming because it's like, why would I drop $6,000, $5,000 on these basses and not know what exactly I was looking for? So, you know, again, I'm not endorsed by Ken Smith or Federa, but I do appreciate fine arts. And the thing about the bass, besides the aesthetics, is the quality of the build is one thing that drove me to buying boutique basses. And I never turned back after I bought my first few boutique basses. It's because the build and the construction of these basses are second to none. These guys, Vinny Federa and Ken Smith, who own these companies, they put their heart and souls, and I know this probably sounds cliche, but they put their heart and souls into these instruments. And by what I mean by this is that they do it the old school way. Like, these guys are literally carving these instruments by hand. It's intense labor. It's intense labor to build you what fits your hand perfectly and et cetera. So the thing is, like, all of us, we're all different, right? I'm a short guy, but I have a big hand, you know, and some people out there may have smaller hands, and some people cannot tolerate heavy basses, and some people don't mind the weight because they're getting a solid tone. So it's like all kinds of variables, right? So that's the reason why I think it's important to not knock boutique basses, to give it a try, because when you try these basses, they're just amazing. You know, as far as the resonance and the sound and just like how it makes you feel soulfully. For me, when I'm playing these basses, I feel the resonance of the vibrations of the strings through the wood. And that's what makes me engage more and go for more things. And also the transparency, right? The transparency on these basses, they're so clean. You know, the funny thing is when I first got my first boutique bass, I was like, why do I sound so bad? Because it was exposing all of my flaws in my techniques and what, and don't look at that as a bad thing. It's a good thing. Because it'll make you a better bass player and make you more professional, because it's gonna expose everything, right? And it's gonna get to the point where it's second nature, and you're just gonna want more and more of that. So, you know, like I said, the price tag shouldn't be the priority. It's really the investment in your passion and investment in the fine arts. And we are living in the golden age because we have the best luthiers for guitars and bass living. And I think it's important to take advantage. If you got to take a loan, if you got to do something to finance the bass, do it. It's highly worth it. I'm not on here because I'm endorsed. I'm on here because I want to let you guys know why it's worth it to buy a boutique bass. I kind of want to think about it like this. Imagine buying a knife set to cut, you know, fruits and veggies or foods, the culinary knife set from your local store, versus buying one out of a magazine that's its boutique. There's a different feeling about those things, right? You know, the one that you would buy that's more expensive, that's probably handcrafted, would feel better, right? It's almost like it's made for that, right? It's literally made for that. It's made for you to cut and to cook and to cook your food better or whatnot. So it's the same thing with the basis, right? And then again, for you guys out there that might have your wife or your girlfriend or whatnot, that might say, wow, you're not gonna ever buy that. It's too expensive. Like you can't justify it to them. I know this may open up a can of worm, but it's kind of like telling them, your wife or your soon-to-be wife, oh, well, let's go to Walmart. Not knocking Walmart, right? But let's go to Walmart to buy your dress, your bridal dress. It probably wouldn't go as well, right? That's a no-brainer. But it's the same thing. It's like, no, they want the dress that fits them properly. It's made for them. It's one of a kind because it's for a special night. I like to think about every gig as a special night because it is. We are very valuable to be selected as musicians and to be able to have the talent to play music and be able to express our art. So the thing is, it's worth it. You know what I mean? It's a special night. It's just like the wedding dress. It's a special night. It's just like your gigs, right? It's a special night. You want the bass that's going to make you amplify and take you to your higher self. And these basses, I'll tell you, it really does. Because when these guys are handcrafting these basses, they're not on this dimension. They're on a higher version of themselves. And you could feel it through the instrument. And the more you feel it, the better you play. So, like I said, guys, just, you know, listen to the video, enjoy it. Please leave your feedback. Let me know which bass that you think sounded better or fits your taste or etc. But feel free to message me, send me any questions. If you are in the market and you're unsure of looking of what you should be looking at, you need to know more about the details of wood combinations, electronics, etc., please reach out to me. But I do look forward to making more of these videos, okay? So guys, please enjoy the video. Like, don't forget to like it, subscribe if you know, like the video, like the channel. But I will be uploading more content.